second set of the day will be played on Korhal Floating Island. Spawning up in the top right-hand position as the Red Terran and Super Ace from STX Seoul. His name is Innovation, considered one of the best players in the world.
His opponent, of course, going for the trademark hyper-aggressive play. In set number one, can he do it again and take down the Super Ace from STX Seoul? His name is Turn, spawning as Blue Terran on the left bottom position of the map.
Yes, indeed. So, we already know Turn's going to be aggressive, but we don't know exactly what Innovation plans on doing. He's opened up with so many different builds and strategies before in this matchup. It's anyone's game, anyone's guess.
Do remember that Innovation is the one who popularized the Hobbit drop in Pro League.
But not outside of Pro League?
Well, some other players did it a long time before Innovation, but it was Innovation who decided to do it constantly when it comes to TBC.
Looks like we're going to have a barracks opening from both players here. So Nott's going to see a command center first. I think that's actually a good decision by both players because Innovation has been known to go for some aggressive Reaper openings. And Turn is Turn. He's going to be aggressive. We see a gas opening following this from Turn. Innovation not going to get his gas, though.
Seems like Innovation doesn't want to be aggressive earlier in the game, instead getting the barracks just to counter what Turn might do slightly earlier in the game. So, there we go. Seems like he's controlling the gas a little bit, so he's just going to try to get a Reaper out as soon as the first Marine finishes. Turn, however, his gas is already complete.
He's just going to have a little bit more gas than his opponent earlier on in the game here. Still no gas quite yet for Innovation because it's, of course, still building here, but it'll go up pretty soon. All right, so Innovation scouting his opponent here, sees what's going on. He's going to harass a little bit with that SCV. We'll eventually get out of there, though. This Marine will scare it off. The SCV runs away, and time will not go down.
So both players open up similarly. It's just that Innovation has a little less gas than his opponent, but the follow-up is going... It's going to be what matters right now. Turn, going for the factory. What is Innovation going to go for?
Well, he's probably going to grab a Reaper here. He could just go for the factory as well. It'll just be slightly delayed. That does look like what he's going to do here because he's saving up his gas. Also saving up a good amount of minerals here as well. So we may see a command center, then the follow-up.
Yeah, well, he does have the 100 gas. He does have the 400 minerals, and he picks the command center.
All right, so getting the command center. We also could see a reactor add-on following with the factory. We do see the reactor go down here. The command center also for Turn being built here. At the natural, though, feeling a little bit more bold.
Mm-hmm, but it's Turn's game now, because now Turn is going to be the one who's going to be who can be a little bit more aggressive than his opponent. Remember, his command center is delayed a little bit, but he got the factory much earlier than his opponent.
And if you actually look at the command center timings, they're almost the same. Mm-hmm. Pretty close here. So just, little differences in the play here between the players, but nothing too drastic. We have a Hellion on the way from Turn right here, and he's already sending three Marines over to his opponent's side of the map, sending one Marine in here, letting it suicide.
But he does scout the reactor and the factory.
And also the command center. He actually sees pretty much everything here. Mm-hmm.
And the biggest key point is that he saw the timing of the building, so he knows that there's not going to be any Hellions out when Turn has a lot of units out. And this is a really nice play. He knows he's slightly ahead. Why not just get more ahead with a third command center?
He has the scouting information, so that's why he's going to go ahead and get that third command center. We have a starport follow-up here from Innovation, though. Planning on getting potentially aggressive here. And a tech lab add-on for the factory.
Hellion is just moving around the map trying to see if there's any hidden SCVs or Marines for Innovation, but Innovation also scouting around his natural, trying to see if it's safe to take the natural right now.
It's looking pretty safe for him to take that. We do have continued Hellion production from Turn here. Might see some mech play from him, actually, because he's really just continuing to, build a lot of Hellions. Tank, Marine, and Viking on the way here for Innovation.
But Innovation gets a nice scan inside the main base. Does see the command center, doesn't see the second gas, but he doesn't see that there's a starport, which means that it's going to be really aggressive play from Turn.
So right, Turn moving forward with some of those Hellions there. He does have the tech lab on his barracks, though, so it looks like he will be going into that bio play. Probably would have gotten a Raven out earlier, actually, if he wanted to go for the mech. The siege tank, though, going to completely prevent these Hellions from doing a lot of damage here. They make his turn. Ignore it, though.
Remember, turn is really aggressive. He doesn't care if he loses one or two Hellions if he can get those 10 SCVs with the 6 Hellions.
Yeah, that's true. All right, factory being repositioned here. We're having 2 barracks go down, 1 being built on that reactor there. No third command center just yet from Innovation.
No third command center, and what's also interesting is that Turn is not getting a starport. Around this time, you need a starport to start producing the metabacks.
Yeah, that's true. So not seeing that, a little bit worrisome. He did delay getting that second gas for such a long time, if you think about it, though.
Yeah, well, that's a trade that he got for getting all those 6 Hellions out. And he did a nice job cutting down the Marine count slightly earlier in the game. Didn't deal a severe economic damage, but certainly a little win for a turn because now Innovation with less Marines. His pushout timing has been delayed a little bit.
Looks like turn, he's adding on a lot of barracks here. He's got a pretty solid Hellion count. This is going to give him really nice map control for a few more minutes in the game. Eventually, Innovation will have enough units to stop that. Behind this, that's a lot of barracks being created here from turn. And behind this, he's also getting 2 engineering bays. And these forces out of position here. Turn may be able to move in at the perfect time and do a lot of damage.
Well, here we go. The Hellions are running inside the main base. And Innovation, what is he going to do? Is he going to turn back? No, he doesn't care. He's going to go for the natural.
Well, don't forget, Innovation actually has the stronger army one-on-one here. So he may just go ahead, not care about those SCVs there, lift up that command center and say, you know what? It's not a big deal. I'm just going to be defensive here and go kill your main base with my units. And big mistake by Innovation.
Innovation, what are you doing?
No.
Two.
That's actually a huge mistake from Innovation there. He lost 2 Vikings for free.
And that also allows Turn to bring back his Hellions to the natural. So now he has a full army once again.
And the Hellions. Oh, look at this. Perfect positioning from Turn here. He's going to snipe down 2 of those tanks, maybe even the third from the high ground. Innovation, what is going on here? He's not playing how we're expecting him to. Turn taking a humongous advantage here. He's got 49 to 32 SCVs, a third command center, superior production. Innovation falling apart.
The word superior does not even describe the situation at this point. Remember, those Hellions that went to the natural base killed a lot of SCVs, and we're expecting, this is going to be a funky base race scenario, but Turn killing the 3 Vikings and Innovation arriving at the natural slightly late gave Turn enough time to take out the siege tanks, and now Turn has more command centers, Turn has more SCVs, Turn has more barracks, Turn has more everything except the Vikings.
Honestly, the decision-making and positioning from Innovation was really bad.
I mean, the tank positioning was nice against the Marines that was inside the main base, but I guess he didn't expect the Hellions to arrive on time.
Yeah, the surround was able to do so much damage there, just targeting down. Everything worked out in Turn's favor. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this,
and
though.
Also,
Innovation scouting this double drop here.
Do remember that Turn did go for a really fast third command center, and Innovation did not scout it, so it went unpunished.
All right, so we have some units from Innovation moving into his main base here. The problem is this is a double-pronged attack here. The Marines have stim and combat shields. They're actually going to force the third command center to get canceled here. Innovation can't do anything. Force the cancel. Oh, this is actually a mistake, too. He's going to... kills the command center, doesn't even let it get canceled. And losing all of those Vikings, loses the medevacs at the same time, a drop in Turn's main base from Innovation. It seems like he's multitasking somewhere else on the map here, but we're just seeing a lot of mistakes from our SDX Soul player today. Uncharacteristic of him.
And even if Innovation kills all the SCVs inside the main base and kills some here, Turn is still far ahead into the game. Remember, the command center has been canceled and then killed. So now Innovation's still down to 2 command centers. And Turn is still attacking the command center inside the main base.
Yes, and it looks like he's forced the cancel almost.
Really hurts.
That medevac's gotta get out of there.
This the same Turn that we were seeing right now? Because he's not playing aggressively right now. He played aggressive earlier in the game. He had a nice lead. And now he knows how to defend.
You know what? If someone didn't tell me any better, I would expect Innovation to be the blue player here.
Yeah.
And Turn to be the red player. But that's not the case today. We're seeing some really solid play from Turn this time around.
Well, Innovation is doing a nice job with the drops, trying to buy as much time as possible.
These Marines, though, in position. Will they be able to snipe it down? Doesn't look like it. Actually, they are going to be able to snipe it. Innovation not able to get a single break this game. He's behind over 30 supply. He's behind in everything right now. Innovation.
I didn't expect turns to be this good at this game compared to innovation.
Yeah, we're getting a bit surprised here. This is not what we expected. The 1-1 is on the way for innovation here. He still doesn't have Stim or Combat Shield. Turn already has those upgrades. He's getting his 2-2 as well. And he also has the third command center moving across the map.
Well,
he had 50 supply.
His opponent, Innovation, does have a lot more siege tanks right now, but look at the Marine count, 43 to only 24. If Turn just gets into a nice position to nice the third base once again, then he could just outright win the game right now.
The only thing that Innovation really has at this point is the tank count.
Yeah.
And it's only one tank. It was a little bit more insult recently. Turn getting ready to move across the map, going for an attack here. He's already up 172 supplies, building more factories so he can increase his tank production here. And this Viking's going to scare away that medevac, narrowly dodging death there from those Marines in that missile turret.
But the key point is that the medevac actually got out of there and Turn scattered it, which means that Turn, he doesn't need to pay attention inside the main base and the third base at the same time.
All right, we have a good siege here from Innovation. He's going to be able to take out a lot of the tanks here from Turn. This is actually a bit of a mistake from our Samsung Kong player. They're losing almost all of his tanks for free. This may be the chance that Innovation needs to get back into this game.
Well, still Turn is quite far ahead in the game. He knows when the third command center has been gone down from his opponent Innovation. He is still sitting on three bases, fully saturated. He can even go for the fourth command center and Innovation cannot punish it. But Turn also needs to be careful because now he gave Innovation enough time to go for the drop place once again. His defense has been phenomenal throughout the whole game,
Innovation,
but this is a mistake.
Turn out of position here. He's going to lose all of these units. What? Where is Turn's attention at? It's not here. He's going to lose all of these units and the medevacs as well. Oh my, this is just this game is starting to turn around here. We're seeing Innovation play a little better and better as the game goes on. More mistakes from Turn. The tanks on the high ground here are going to get sniped off, it looks like, from the Marines. So good micro from Turn, but is it enough?
Yeah, well, Innovation's doing a nice job cutting the siege tanks once again, and he is going to micro in this position, but I don't know, man. You're seeing two different turns within the same game.
All right, so we need to backtrack a little bit here and talk about
some
things. First of all, before we do that, the supply right now, 128, the 168 or 9 right now, it's starting to even out a little bit more. Innovation, he made a lot of mistakes earlier on in the game. He lost a lot.
Oh.
He was very far behind. But when it started coming to the engagements, Turn was the one that got defeated later on.
And also, Turn made up to 81 SCVs, a little bit more than what you need on three base economy. So he does have a nice lead when it comes to the supply count. But, you know, 10 of those could have been freed for more Marines, 10
exactly.
more Marines, or 5 more, you know, a little more siege tanks.
The army supplies are actually a lot closer because of how much more SCVs Turn has a renovation. Well, now it's only about 10, but beforehand it was like...
Yes.
It was a lot more
60 SCVs to like 80 SCVs.
Yeah. All right, Innovation. He has to defend against this attack, but
He doesn't have Marines.
Turn, he's got really good coverage here. Looks like he's going to be able to kill all of the tanks. He does take a good amount of damage here, but the supply is still in his favor.
But this really hurts Innovation because now he lost that area. He's losing the third command center, which is something that he really needs at this point.
He has to keep that third base or he's going to be out of this game.
But Turn, he has a reinforcement. His opponent Innovation has a lot of medevacs out, but not that many Marines and army compared to his opponent Turn.
And Turn continuing the shell on this third base over here. Starting to get low kills off the refiner. We have a tank moving into position here to start hitting some of those Marines in that corner there. Innovation has to use a lot of his resources to repair that base right now. And the Marines moving forward, trying to snipe off those units, but they're getting a little bit out of position here. Marines dying on both sides. This one tank will get taken out, though. Innovation, is he going to lose the turn here? Things are looking worse and worse for him.
It's a battle of the reinforcements because now Innovation can actually drop on top of the siege tanks. No Marines by Turn. He needs those Marines to be over there right now. If not, Innovation can actually hold the third base.
Innovation, if he can hold this third, there's still a chance for him to take this game. The drops, though, they have to work well on these siege tanks. They're doing a good amount of damage, killing off one of them, getting a second one as well. The third one most likely low on health. In addition to that, but the siege tanks continue to attack this base.
And the reinforcement did arrive, which means that Turn has better army in the third base of Innovation. Innovation, he's well defended on the right side, but the problem is the command center is already under fire, and Turn, he knows that he is well fortified in this position, so now he's going to go for a double prong attack.
Going for that double pawn attack there. Could be a very smart move from him. Innovation, he's only at 141 supply compared to the pretty much maxed out Terran army of turns. Seeing that fourth command center getting taken as well, he's going to simply move some units over there and be able to counter that. Counter going in the natural. There's not a lot of units here to defend against this. The SCV's moving over to this location. GG! Called from Innovation. Turn taking game number two. Who is this guy? Where did he come from? Why is he playing so good?
I'm completely baffled right now. We don't see this play from Turn. We see a full aggression from Turn, and he fit. You know, once he doesn't do enough damage, he slowly starts to die. You know, he did a nice damage against the SCVs, and Innovation had a nice siege tank count, but he was just not in position. Also, the biggest key point is that Innovation did not scout the Dark Command Center from Turn. It went unpunished.
That's true. It did go unpunished. Obviously, well, you know what? We have to go into a quick commercial break. We're going to talk more about this game when we get back. There's a lot to discuss. Don't go anywhere, guys. This is the SK Planet Pro League.